Paintings and murals have three main subject types. The first is figurative, the second is narrative, and the third is diagrammatic. And we have discussed this a little bit already. But for the first type, figurative, it is by far the most important, because even narrative paintings are telling stories about people, and people are figures. Diagrammatic type paintings are often to do with mandalas, and mandalas include figures. Astrological charts include figures, etc. So figures are the most important. But just to discuss figures, we also have to understand that there are two main categories of figures. We have the non-iconic and we have the iconic. Non-iconic figures are found in foundational Buddhism and Mahayana Buddhism, so Sutrayana and Mahayana. And they're based on narrative. They're based on the stories told in the sutras. They're based on the Buddha being in a certain place and being questioned by an arhat or a bodhisattva of some kind. And they're non-iconic in that the artist can paint them in any way they choose. Now, of course, the Buddha figure has adopted its and taken on its own sense of iconography, basically since really the time of the Gandharan period, and also the Gupta, and then later the Pala. We have a very clear idea of what a Buddha iconographic figure is. Now, iconic figures really have to do with Tantra and Tantra theory and Vajrayana Buddhism. An iconic figure in this sense of what we're discussing means a fixed meditational form of a human type subject, a deity type subject, a figure that has a face, a torso, arms, legs. So the Vajrayana figures are fixed in their appearance, in their number of faces, their arms, in how they look, in whether or not they have, such as Achala, whether they have one eye looking up, one eye looking down, and the upper lip exposed, and the teeth biting down on the lower lip. I mean, this is fixed. The artist does not have the ability to change this. So we have tantric figures, which are iconic. We have Sutrayana and Mahayana figures are non-iconic. And then based on that, then we have the three moods, you know, the peaceful, semi-peaceful, wrathful, and then wrathful. Then we have the 11 figurative forms for all figures. It's a broad listing. Then we have the 11 types of deities. So this, now aside from this, we also can talk about composition size, canvas size, be it a mural or a scroll work. There are simple paintings, simple compositions with one deity, and then there are complex compositions with a large central figure and multiple secondary figures related or unrelated to the central figure. So this is just an overview of figurative art.